Chris Bishop, I wasn't aware you're into dus-dus music.
I'm into loud, distorted guitars. I just want to make that really clear. I'm not a dance guy, but...
You're not a dance guy?
No. Are you?
No, God.
Are you into D&B and trance and all that?
No.
No.
Kenny Rogers and Neil Diamond.
Yeah, okay. Well,
your tax cut is still coming, but at what cost? Finance Minister Nicola Willis says it won't be possible for the government to hit surplus until 2028, and even that's not a given. National were very quick to call out Labor for what they said was economic mismanagement when the shoe was on the other foot last year. So we are back to the old favourite question, is now the right time for tax cuts? Well, here for more is our reunited captains panel of Labor's Kieran McAnulty and National's Chris Bishop. Morena korua.
Good morning.
Chris, I'll start with you. I mean, no surplus for the next 4 years. The economy is a bit depressed. And we heard from economist Isham Mabil Ekoab. He described the government's strategy as a pamphlet, light on details, high on electioneering. Your government was caught flat-footed. What do you say to that?
Well, the budget policy statement is a short document by definition. The full details get released at the end of May when the budget comes out. Well, look, we've inherited a very set of tricky economic circumstances. A big increase in spending over the last 6 years, 84%. Debt is high, inflation is high, and of course New Zealanders don't have a lot to show for that. So, and of course low growth as well. So we got those December GDP numbers out.
So then why would you offer tax cuts?
But, well, a couple of reasons. Firstly, New Zealanders have not had a tax cut since 2010. And we think that's time they get tax relief and get help with the cost of living. And secondly, it is possible to do that at the same time as moving resources from the back office to the front line. We also campaigned on it and we intend to deliver on it. So we are absolutely going to deliver tax relief in the budget and people will see the details in a couple of months.
Kieran, you're listening to this. Is now the right time for tax cuts, given economists have warned not to give tax cuts at this stage?
Yeah, look, when the National Party loses economists, they really should take pause for thought there. That when you've got the likes of Cameron Bagri and Brad Olson and others saying, or at least questioning whether this is a smart move at the moment, it is a hard thing to sell, I think, when New Zealanders are losing and the things that they care about, and there's questions about other things that really make a difference, like school lunches, etc., when the government is giving $2.9 billion to landlords and then say, no, we can't afford the services that Kiwis enjoy. No, I don't think this is time for tax cuts. The National Party's plan didn't add up before the election and it doesn't add up now. And I think the most telling thing about the release of the policy statement was that the allowance that every finance minister leading up to a budget has announced at this point wasn't announced yesterday. Something's not right. Someone doesn't agree with someone else. And so Nicola couldn't do what is the convention and release what the allowance is for the budget. So it's actually not good enough. It's not good enough to say, oh, well, it'll be below this point. If the finance minister basically should just do what everyone else does and be upfront with the Kiwis as to what's going to be spent.
The difference between us and between Nicola and Grant Robertson is that Grant would publish an allowance in the budget policy statement and then break it in every budget. We're intending to publish a budget allowance in the budget and stick to it. That's part of the reason why we've got such big increases in spending is that Grant.
But Chris, we do know that former Prime Minister John Key, he also talked about tax cuts, but he held off for a year. Do you think Nicola Willis would consider this and maybe hold it off for a year?
The National Party campaigned, everyone remembers the election campaign. It was the centrepiece of the election that the National Party alongside our coalition government won to deliver tax relief because New Zealanders have faced a prolonged cost of living crisis and have not had a tax cut since 2010. That is 14 years that New Zealanders have been waiting for adjustments to tax brackets and more New Zealanders are paying higher and higher rates of tax. We think we can get spending under control, get the debt curve trending down and deliver meaningful tax relief to middle-income New Zealanders and we will deliver that in the budget.
Your question at the start, at what cost? That's the key issue here. Mm. And we're already starting to see the cost of these tax cuts, but the real answer to that won't be revealed till later. The forecasts show that there's nearly $14 billion less revenue coming into the government. They're choosing to give what revenue they do have away And I think we're going to feel that in reduced services over time. And that's actually not what Kiwis want.
It's not giving it away. It is letting New Zealanders keep more of the money that they earned in the first place. I think that's all quite right. A telling comment, that giving away things is equivalent to letting people keep more of what they earn. It's different.
2.9 million.
Okay, let's just move on to another topic. I want to bring into the passport with Fred again. Chris Bishop, I wasn't aware you're into dus-dus music. You could be the minister of the dus-dus music. But Tamitha Paul, who would have thought you would be teaming up with a Green MP to help get this across the line?
I'm into loud, distorted guitars. I just want to make that really clear. I'm not a dance guy, but...
You're not a dance guy?
No. Are you?
No, God.
Are you into DMB and trance and all that?
No. Kenny Rogers and Neil Diamond.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'm sort of more 1990s grunge and She-Hard and all that sort of stuff. But anyway, my role's been massively overstated. So Tamitha Paul just texted me and said, hey, this DJ, has been asked to go and... play in Australia with Fred again, can you help? And I said, well, there's an urgent passport application. She should just apply. That's literally basically all I did. I just said there's an urgent thing she can apply for, and it turns out that's exactly what she did. So my role's been massively overstated. I just tried to be helpful. That's all.
Look, it's not a good look, but I don't think there's much to it. That people that were involved have fronted and said, look, we tried to help. All we've done is point people in the right direction or connect them to those that make the decisions. I'm going to take people at their word there. It's a lesson for everyone that processes are there for a reason. But at the end of the day, public servants and politicians want to try and be helpful when they can.
Kieran, Chris, good to talk to you both. Thank you.
Cheers.